11. Find the complex number z. So whenever you have to find the complex number z, satisfying the equation z plus root 2 mod z plus 1 plus I equals to 0. Assume that z equals to x plus iy. Okay. So z equals to x plus iy plus root 2 into, in place of z write x plus iy plus 1 modulus plus I equals to 0. It implies x plus iy plus root 2, change it to a plus ib form. So the real part is x plus 1 and imaginary part is iy plus I equals to 0. So x plus iy plus root 2, and we know that modulus of x plus iy is under root x square plus y square. So modulus of x plus 1 plus iy is x plus 1 whole square plus y square plus I equals to 0. It implies x plus iy plus, you can write these two roots inside the same brackets. Plus I equals to 0. Write the real parts together. So x is real and this whole square root is real. And in imaginary part, iy plus I, take I common. So y plus 1 equals to, now change this also to a plus ib form. So it is 0 plus 0i. Compare both sides. The real coefficient, both sides. Left hand side real coefficient is x plus root 2 into x plus 1 whole square plus y square equals to 0. It implies x equals to, so write comparing real part both sides, real coefficient or real part both sides. Minus square root of 2 into x plus 1 whole square plus y square, and to remove the square root, square both sides. So x square equals to, the square root will be removed, 2 into x plus 1 whole square, or you can even expand this x plus 1 whole square. So it is x square plus 2x plus 1 plus y square. Open the bracket, 2x square plus 4x plus 2 plus y square. It implies, transfer them to the same side. 2x square. Yes, ask your doubt.
Sir, it will be 2y square.
Yes. 2x square minus x square plus 4x plus 2 plus 2y square equals to 0. So x square, any other doubt?
No, sir.
Okay, so always pay attention so that you can find the mistakes and help and take part in solving the question. Now comparing imaginary coefficients both sides. So imaginary coefficient is y plus 1 in left hand side and 0 in right hand side. So it is directly giving y equals to minus 1. So it would have been easier if we have first found the value of y. No problem though. Now we substitute y equals to minus 1 in equation number 1. So x square plus 4x plus 2 into minus 1 whole square plus 2 equals to 0. That is x square plus 4x plus 4 equals to 0, which is x plus 2 whole square equals to 0. So x equals to minus 2. And we have assumed that z equals to x plus iy. Therefore, minus 2 plus I into value of y is minus 1. So z equals to minus 2 minus I is the final answer. Understood?
Yes, sir.
In this step, if we have first compared y equal plus 1 with 0, the y equals to minus 1. So we can directly substitute it in this. Na? So some steps can be saved. Okay. Understood? Now the next doubt is in 24. Solve for z. In all these types of equations, we have to assume that z equals to x plus iy. So z bar means, as it is given that z bar equals to iz cube. Z bar means?
So z bar is the conjugate of z.
Means x minus iy. If z equals to x plus iy.
Yes, sir.
So z bar is x minus iy equals to I into z cube x plus iy whole cube. It implies x minus iy equals to I into x cube plus I cube y cube plus 3x into iy into x plus iy. It implies x minus iy equals to I into x cube, I cube means minus I, y cube plus 3 x square y I plus 3 x y square I square. It implies x minus I y equals to I into x cube, and this I square becomes minus 1. So this term is minus 3xy square. And take I common from these two. So I into 3x square y is positive. So it is written first minus y cube. But the game is still not over. We will multiply this I with these two terms. So I into x cube minus 3xy square plus I into I square into 3x square y minus y cube. Now we know that I square is minus 1. So if we substitute I square equals to minus 1, x minus I y equals to minus 3x square y minus y cube plus I into x cube minus 3xy square. Now comparing the real parts both sides, x equals to minus 3x square y minus y cube. Open the bracket, minus 3x square y plus y cube, take it as equation number 1. Compare the imaginary coefficient both sides. This side where coefficient of I is minus y, this is real part. This is imaginary part. Minus y equals to x cube minus 3xy square, which is equation number 2. So now we will solve these two equations simultaneously. Think about any method to solve this. This is x equals to minus 3x square y plus y cube. This is minus y equals to x cube minus 3xy square. The question is z bar equals to iz cube. Okay. Check once z bar is x minus yy plus I into x cube plus I cube y cube plus 3xiy into x plus iy. So x minus iy equals to I into x cube minus iy cube plus 3x square y into I plus 3x square xy square into I square, which is minus 1. So x cube minus 3xy square plus I into 3x square y minus y cube. I into x cube minus 3xy square plus I square means minus 1 into 3x square y minus y cube. Okay, so x equals to minus 3x square y minus y cube, and opening the bracket, it is giving y cube minus 3x square y. Okay, so everything is correct. So if we first take y common from equation 1, right hand side of equation 1, y is common. So y square minus 3x square. That is, we can write x by y equals to y square minus 3x square. And then x is taken common from right hand side of equation. X into x square minus 3y square. So minus y by x equals to x square minus 3y square, equation number 4. Now, if we further take the reciprocal of both sides, so x by y and minus y by x, or if first we take the reciprocal, it is minus x by y, it is 1 upon x square minus 3y square. Taking invertendo both side. Okay. Now x by y is y square minus 3x square. So minus y square minus 3x square equals to 1 upon x square minus 3y square. Cross multiplying. First multiply by minus 3x square minus y square. Then cross multiplying x square minus 3y square equals to 1. Open the bracket. 3x to the power 4 minus x square y square minus 9, this is a 9, x square y square plus 3y to the power 4 minus 1 equals to 0. It is not working. So how to factorize this? Means if we continue this equation 2 as y equals to multiplying both sides minus 1, x cube minus 3xy square becomes 3xy square minus x cube. And y equals to taking x common 3y square minus x square. Now equation from equation 1, if we substitute the value of x, y cube minus 3x square y into 3y square minus x square. So y equals to y is common in first bracket into minus 3x square plus y square into 3y square minus x square. And then transfer all the terms to the same side. Y into y square minus 3x square into 3y square minus x square minus y equals to 0. Then take y common. So y square minus 3x square into 3y square minus x square minus 1 equals to 0. Means either y equals to 0 or this term y square minus 3x square into 3y square minus 1 equals to 0. Okay. Which we have already obtained from this relation also. Y square minus 3x square. This is 3x square minus y square into 3y square minus x square. So x square minus 3y square. It will give the same result actually. If you multiply both the brackets with minus 1 minus into minus plus. And when we expand it, it is giving 3x to the power 4 minus x square. And on simplifying, final equation is this, which is not giving any real values or any real relations between x and y. Okay. And when it is not giving any relation between x and y, so it cannot be solved. Is that clear to you? So leave this. Not real well relation between x and y is shown. Okay. So only one real value of y is there, which is 0. And when we substitute this value of y in equation number 1, it is giving x is also 0. So z is 0 plus 0y, that is z equals to 0 is the answer for z bar equals to izq. Is that clear to you now?
Yes, sir.
Now question 25 is also of the complex equation. Z equals to x plus iy will be substituted in this also. And it is mod z plus 1 equals to z plus 2 into 1 plus I, and we have to find the value of z. Now, if we substitute x plus iy plus 1 equals to x plus iy plus 2 plus 2i mod x plus 1 plus iy, write it in a plus ib form. Equals to x plus 2, write the real parts first, then I is common from the remaining parts. Under root of this is x plus 1 whole square plus y square equals to x plus 2 plus I into y plus 2. So comparing imaginary part both sides, at this side doesn't contain any imaginary part, means this is 0y. So y plus 2 equals to 0 with imaginary parts. Is that clear to you? Means y equals to minus 2. Understood, na?
Yes, sir.
And in this, comparing the real parts, both sides. Under root x plus 1 whole square plus y square in left hand side and x plus 2 in the right hand side, left hand side x plus 1 plus y square. And squaring both sides, x plus 1 whole square plus y square equals to x plus 2 whole square. Now the value of y is minus 2. Expand it. Expand the x square bracket, x plus 1 whole square, this side also. X square plus 2x plus 1 plus 4 equals to x square plus 4x plus 4. So x square both side cancelled out, 2x minus 4x minus 2x, 4, 4 cancelled out equals to minus 1, x equals to half. So x equals to half, y equals to minus 2, z equals to x plus iy, that is half minus 2y is the answer. Is that clear to you everyone?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Answer is
half minus 2y. Okay. So the next doubt is in question number 29. You have solved 26, 27, 28. No doubt in them.
Yes, sir, I have solved some questions from middle were left, but most of the questions I have solved.
26, 27, 28th only, na? So doubt is in 29th only. In this also we will do the same. Means putting z equals to x plus iy. Okay? So this equation, modulus z minus 4 upon z minus 8 equals to 1. And I have told you a property that modulus z1 by z2 equals to mod z1 upon mod z2. So it is mod z minus 4 upon mod z minus 8 equals to 1. Is that clear to you? So cross multiplying, it is giving mod z minus 4 equals to mod z minus 8. Put z equals to x plus iy minus 4 equals to modulus x plus iy minus 8. It implies x minus 4 plus iy modulus equals to x minus 8 plus iy. It implies under root of x minus 4 whole square plus y square equals to under root of x minus 8 whole square plus y square. Squaring both sides, x minus 4 whole square plus y square equals to x minus 8 whole square plus y square. Y square cancelled out. X square minus 8x plus 16 equals to x square minus 16x plus 64. X square both sides cancelled out. Okay. Minus 8x plus 16x. 16x is transferred to left hand side. 64 minus 16. So 8x equals to 48, that is x equals to 6. Now take the second equation, which is modulus of z minus 12 over z minus 8i equals to 5 by 3. Separate using this formula, hai na? So mod z minus 12 over mod z minus 8i equals to 5 by 3. It implies cross multiplying 3 into mod z minus 12 equals to 5 into mod z minus 8i. It implies 3 into x plus iy minus 12 equals to 5 into x plus iy minus 8i. It implies 3 into x minus 12 plus iy equals to 5 into x plus I into y minus 8. It implies 3 into root x minus 12 whole square plus y square equals to 5 into root x square plus y minus 8 whole square. Squaring both sides, 3 square becomes 9 into x minus 12 whole square plus y square equals to 5 square is 25 into x square plus y minus 8 whole square. So 9 into x square plus, and we have x equals to 6 also, na? So use this value of x also to simplify it further. 6 minus 12 whole square plus y square equals to 25 into x square is 6 square plus y minus 8 whole square. So 9 into 6 minus 12, 6 square plus y square equals to 25 into 36 plus y minus 8 whole square. It implies 36 nines are 324 plus 9y square equals to 25 into 36, 900, na? Plus 25 into, expand this y minus 8 whole square also. So it is y square plus 64 minus 16y. implies 324 plus 9y square equals to 900 plus 25y square plus 25 into 64, 1600 minus 84, 400y. It implies 25y square minus 9y square, 16y square minus 400y, 2400 minus 2500 minus 300, 2200. So it is 2176, correct? Divide throughout by 16. Y square minus 25y minus 16 ones are 16. 57, 16, 3 is a 48, 16, 6 is a 96 equals to 0. So the final equation is y square minus 25 minus 136 equals to 0. Is it plus? Yes, yes, it is plus. S 17, it is a 136. Y common into y minus 17 minus 8 common into y minus 17 equals to 0. It implies y minus 17 into y minus 8 equals to 0. So y equals to 17 or y equals to 8. So there are two answers. Value of x is only 1, 6. And for each value of x, there are two values of 1. And we have assumed that z equals to x plus iy. So it is 6 plus 17i. Or z equals to x plus i. So 6 plus 8i. So two answers are there. Two values of z are satisfying the given complex equation. Is that clear to everyone?
Yes, sir.
Understood or not?
Yes, sir.
So next doubt is question number 12. If z1 equals to 3 plus 2y and z2 equals to 1 minus 3i, then find the modulus of z1. So modulus of z1 is, what will be the modulus of z1? Will it not be root 3
sir, plus 2 square? The 3 square plus 2 square, the root 1.
So it is root 13, okay? And modulus of z2 is under root of 1 square, that is root 10. Also verify that mod z1, z2. So first find z1, z2 only. Means by multiplying z1 and z2, we can find z1, z2. 3 plus 2i into 1 minus 2i. Use the formula for multiplication. What is the formula? 3 into 1 minus 2 into minus 3 plus I into 3 into minus 3 plus 2 into 1. So 3 plus 6, 9. Plus I into minus 7. So the answer is 9 minus 7i. Okay. Now we find mod z1, z2, that is under root of 9 square
plus 9 square plus 7 square.
So it is 81 plus 49, that is root 130, that is root 13 into 10, which is equal to then 1st we write the left hand side again, mod z1 z2 equals to root 13 into root 10. Now value of root 13 is mod z1. So mod z1 z2 equals to mod z1, and value of root 10 is mod z2 into mod z2. Hence root. Is that clear to you?
Yes, sir.
Any other doubt? So the next doubt is in question number 19. Z1 equals to 3 plus I. Z2 equals to 1 plus 4i. Verify that mod z1 plus z2. First find z1 plus z2. So it is 3 plus I plus 1 plus 4. 3 plus 1, 4 plus 5i. So mod z1 plus z2 equals to under root of 4 square plus 5 square under root of 16 plus 25 plus to square root of 14. Mod z1 plus z2 equals to square root of 41. Then find mod z1. Mod z1 is root 3 square plus 1 square root 10. Find mod z2. Square root of 1 square plus 4 square. Then root 17. Now which one is greater? You can check. If you find mod z1 plus mod z2, it is root 10 plus root 17. Now you know that root 10. Find the approximate value, which is 3.1 something, na? Find the square root of 17, 4, 4, 16. This is 331, 961. Or check for two digits. And the square root of 17 is 4.1681. Okay, 4.1 will be okay. Add them. 7.24. Okay. And the square root of 41 is 6.5 square is 42.25. 6.4, 40.96. Okay, it is exact 6.4. So clearly, which one is greater?
Sir, Z1 plus mod Z1 plus mod Z2.
It means mod Z1 plus Z2 is less than mod Z1 plus mod Z2. Understood?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
When numbers are given, we have to work on numbers only, okay? No other things are required. Any other doubt?
Yes, sir.